I spent 2 months chasing a rumor that nobody really seemed to care about. Honestly, it sounded ridiculous and super niche, so obviously I had to test it. Okay, so the rumor went something like this. If you had an AMD GPU and an NVIDIA GPU installed in the same system, you could enable DLSS in games that support it, but then force AMD FSR to upscale the graphics in the Radeon settings control panel, basically using your AMD GPU as a coprocessor. It seemed more of a rumor, a theory, a myth. And so, as you might expect, I became obsessed. I spent hours scouring the internet for any information regarding coprocessing. I asked friends, gurus, and even a robot who tried to gatekeep knowledge that it deemed unnatural for humans to possess. I bought games. So many games. And tested them late into the night. Look, I have no problem admitting I'm the worst person to do a scientific test. I'm not very technically knowledgeable, but maybe if I can create some interest, the real scientists can step up. I would have unraveled, as you who follow my channel well know, but my family kept me grounded because they joined in on the testing. We ended up rediscovering a hobby and bonding over it.
I'm just trying to make you go faster.
The problem with simple sounding problems is that they rarely are simple. Firstly, DLSS and FSR, it's relatively new tech that's missing in most games, let alone both implementations. But secondly, in most titles, enabling one completely disables the other. So then you would need to use the GPU control panel to force driver settings for the game. But here was my second problem. The way Xbox Game Pass packages its games makes it difficult, if not practically impossible, for the GPU software settings to access them. There are some workarounds for some games, but overall, I knew if I was going to test this properly, I had to suck it up, open my wallet, and buy the games on Steam. And even when they do work together, a little bit of spoilers, the order in which you apply them totally changes the results. And if I hadn't noticed that, I could have missed out on some really important data. Finally, I noticed that in some games, enabling DLSS frame gen would either visibly lock VSync in the menus or invisibly lock it. I was playing on a 60Hz monitor, so I needed to stick to modern games that were too hard for my system to run natively at anywhere close to 60Hz, but also support DLSS frame gen and were able to be detected in Radeon settings. No wonder this is a myth, but I wasn't ready to give up. In fact, if anything, I was more obsessed. But then I found it. Ghost of Tsushima on the PC. Supposedly, it was one of the few games that actually allowed DLSS and FSR to be used together, one for upscaling and the other for frame generation. Wincing, I shelled out the cash and ran a full battery of late night tests, swapping combinations, monitoring frame rate, and checking subjective visual quality. When I forced FSR 3 frame gen, my NVIDIA latency overlay showed zero latency.
What?
You see, I was using Radeon's FSR frame gen, which runs on the AMD GPU, and NVIDIA's latency overlay doesn't see what AMD is doing, so it just reports zero. This little example of the lack of cross-vendor performance monitoring was the proof that I need to come to a conclusion. Now check my work, but it seems to confirm that when you add FSR into the mix with an AMD GPU as a coprocessor, performance increases. Now both technologies' performance and quality changes as you increase resolution. So this really is a matter of testing to find the sweet spot, and it will be very subjective. For Ghost of Tsushima and my system, double FSR 3 outperformed any combination of DLSS with measurable data, sometimes significantly. However, subjectively, adding DLSS in the mix in some form increased visual quality. The key takeaway is yes, if all of the stars aligned, you can use an AMD GPU to offload work from your NVIDIA GPU. Co-processing isn't a myth. But honestly, the reason I started this entire journey had nothing to do with DLSS or FSR. I design and sell tiny PC cases, and my customers ask me for hardware recommendations all the time. The Minisforum Ai X1 Pro is the first mini PC I've seen that balances all compromises. Call me out in the comments if you think there's something else out there better. But look at this. It has an internal power supply. 3 PCIe 4.0 M.2 slots for expansion. I can't stress how important this is for my kind of building. It has dual USB-C 4.0 with DisplayPort pass-through, which is a big deal for adding another GPU into the mix. course, out of the box, it does have its own GPU, a Radeon 890M, which gives you about PS4 Pro level graphics performance. I played a lot of my games over the first month, Civilization, the Resident Evil series. It's fine, 1080p, no problems, but expanding this thing out is really what makes it magical. Surprisingly, it also has name brand RAM and SSD options, and they actually perform quite well, all for under $1,000. Does this make you think twice about overpaying for an already ridiculously overpriced entry-level GPU? Does me. You can drop this beast of a machine into a Tiny, pair it with a slim 12-volt power supply like the Bell ABC-180, a perfect fit by the way, and slot something wild in like the A4000 single-slot GPU, which, by today's standards, is actually pretty affordable, sadly. And if budget isn't a concern, the A4000 Ada generation would make for an absolutely insane build in this form factor. For all my DLSS testing, I used this A2000 Ada generation GPU. It's more than enough GPU for me, and would pair beautifully with this Tiny build, though fitting inside would be trickier than a single slot card. Besides, that's not how I want to use this machine anyway, because Miniforum have another ace up their sleeve. They also sent me their Oculink eGPU dock, and for $99, it's an absolute no-brainer. It behaved exactly like a PCIe slot. No wake issues, no driver quirks, no measurable performance loss. I've already tested bandwidth scaling with a 4090 in a previous video. For this class of GPU, this connection isn't holding anything back. Honestly, Minisforum is killing it. They were already one of the most interesting small form factor brands around, but this setup proves they understand what enthusiasts like me actually want. But this project, it didn't just teach me about GPUs or frame gen. It reminded me why I fell in love with the small form factor in the first place. To prove my point, check out this quote that I gave during an interview with the Small Form Factor Network over 10 years ago. Many of my fondest gaming memories include a friend jabbing me in my rib cage with his or her elbow as we attempted to claim victory with our console controllers. There's something really special to me about gaming in the living room and sitting next to the person that you're playing with. Online matchmaking is convenient. No, it's amazing. I'm probably married to my wife of 15 years in part from her ability to date long distance through World of Warcraft. But with this new PC console setup, we laid in bed and fought zombies.
You fell into a grave with a zombie?
Yeah, I fell in an accident the first time, but then there was something I wanted in there.
Admired minifigs.
Somebody had to animate that.
And solve puzzles. I'm filled with gratitude to have a second chance to remember what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. And honestly, it's because of this little computer. Okay, so before I wrap up, I want to thank Floyd from Minisforum for sending me the A1 X1 Pro early so I could do my test with it. And Floyd, you better make sure that these are available in stock in April because my customers are going to want this. Another big shout to Johnny Thunder. Without him letting me borrow his Ada A2000, I literally would not have been able to make this video because I couldn't get a hold of an NVIDIA GPU. Also, of course, thank you to all of my Patreon and Discord supporters who follow my madness and let me geek out in public. I'm sad that I couldn't find more games that support co-processing, but I'm glad I spent the time proving it does work. Hopefully, you viewers will do your own tests and we can get the attention of game developers that can actually allow real co-processing in their games, like Ghost of Tsushima. Here's the key takeaway. It's not about the hardware, the GPUs, the mini PCs, even my own tiny computer cases. What matters is how you use this hobby to bring a little more fun and family time into your life. Don't forget why you started. Peace.